Hey everybody, Keith Dotson here, and in this video, we'll start by revisiting video footage I shot in March of 2023 when I was in Meridian shooting abandoned buildings and found this place. This was the e.f.young Junior Hotel in Meridian, and I came here to shoot the beautiful weathered old sign that once hung over this corner, but sadly I was too late, it had been removed. But while here, I spoke to a gentleman who told me that the hotel had been condemned and was scheduled to be demolished within a month. This was Young's Beauty Shop. This was a barber shop. And this was Clayton's barber shop. Down on the end was a separate business called The Ruins, and there was some controversy about whether it could survive a demolition of the adjacent Young Hotel, and as we will see shortly, it did not survive. By the way, take note of the condition of this tile entry that I think was quite nice and historic and should have been saved and preserved for historical reasons. E.F. Young Jr. was an entrepreneur in Meridian, Mississippi who started a company that made hair products specifically for African Americans. He opened the E.F. Young Jr. Hotel in Meridian in 1946. It was a Green Book listed location and the only one where black people could rent a room within a 90-mile radius. The hotel was part of a collection of black-owned businesses in this district that catered to the needs of black travelers. Keep in mind that Meridian was a railroad hub and there was a train that stopped nearby. These businesses provide safe respite for people during the Jim Crow era of the Deep South. In later years, the hotel became somewhat disreputable and became more like a flophouse until it was closed in 1978 when it was used as office space for the hair products company for a while. After becoming vacant altogether, it began to deteriorate. Still owned by the Young family, there were unsuccessful efforts to use federal grants to restore the building, and in 2021, the street alongside the building was closed and the building condemned due to safety concerns. For some reason, I really felt responsible for recording the last day of this building, and I wanted to document the destruction on video, but I couldn't get anyone to give me a solid date for the demolition. We even spoke to someone from the Young family on the telephone who said there was no date set, but within a month, it was indeed gone. What you see straight ahead with the red walls was an adjacent business called The Ruins. It was irrevocably damaged during the demolition of the Young Hotel. This is more or less where that typewriter was sitting in the earlier footage. And here's that tile entry. If you recall, it was in pretty good condition, but it was severely damaged during the demo project. It's a shame because that could have been carefully lifted and reconstructed for a museum exhibit or something. Here on the corner was a beauty shop. And this would have been Clayton's barbershop. Now, when I came here, I kind of thought this would be the end of the video. But then across the street, near another derelict building, I spotted the old neon sign for the Young Hotel sitting in the grass. Just look at this thing. I shot it on my previous visit, but this is a much better opportunity. Now, why did someone paint a portrait of General Sherman here? I can only guess that it's a comment on the destruction that surrounds us here, equivocating it to Sherman's march to the sea and the burning of Atlanta. Who knows the artist's motivation? Thank you. We thought you might also enjoy seeing this old Dr. Pepper wall ad and all the incredible textures in this vacant lot across the street. Thanks for watching. Be sure to visit my website at keithdotson.com.